The second folder in your resource tree is called Sounds. You can create a new sound by using the resource drop-down menu, selecting the Create a Sound speaker icon from the toolbar, or right-clicking on the Sounds folder in the resource tree and selecting Create Sound. Once you do, a Sound Properties window will open up. Here you can give a name to your new sound. Much like the naming conventions talked about in the Sprites lesson, you'll want to preface the name of this file with some sort of code. You can use a three-letter code such as SND or SFX. You can use just the letter S, as long as you didn't use the letter S for sprite. Remember, you want to keep your names unique. You can also put an underscore in between the code at the beginning and the name of the file if you wish. Personally, I use SND for sound and BGM for music. To the right of the text field for name, you'll find three buttons. The first one is Load Sound from File. If you click on that button, GameMaker will open an Explorer window. From here you can select where your audio file is located on your computer. Typically, GameMaker accepts WAV and MP3 files. You may also use Vorbis OGG files. It's a good idea to use WAV for sound effects and MP3s for music. Once you've selected your file, you can click Open. Depending on whether you selected WAV or MP3, GameMaker may automatically select an attribute for the particular file you've selected. The next two buttons are Play the Source Sample and Stop the Sound. If you click on Play the Source Sample, GameMaker will play the current sound you've loaded up, or song that you've loaded up, and continually loop it. Then you can click on the Stop button to stop the looping play. You'll notice just below the Name text field, a section that says File Name and the file you've selected. This just lets you know which file you've selected. Below that, you'll find a box called Attributes with four selections. As I said, GameMaker may have automatically selected an attribute for you depending on the file you've selected. Usually, this is fine. But let's just go through them so you understand what each of the four selections mean. The first selection says uncompressed, not streamed, in memory, low CPU. In GameMaker, you have the option to compress your audio file or not compress your audio file. Keep in mind that uncompressed audio increases the size of your final game file, whereas compressed audio makes your game slightly smaller in size. GameMaker compresses your audio files down to OGG files. So uncompressed leaves your audio file as a WAV or an MP3. Not streamed doesn't really matter when it's uncompressed. We'll get into what streaming means in the fourth option. In memory means that the audio file will be in the memory of the computer of the person playing your game. Also, uncompressed audio is not very taxing on the CPU, so it's listed as low CPU. The next three options are compressed options. The first one is compressed, not streamed, in memory, higher CPU. This means that the audio file has been compressed down to an OGG file. Not streamed means your file will be uncompressed in full whenever it's called upon in your game. This audio file will be in memory and it will use higher CPU resource. This is because it'll be uncompressed in full each time it is used. The third option is compressed, uncompress on load, not streamed, higher memory, low CPU. Once again, this means your audio file will be compressed down to an OGG file. However, each time the player loads the game, all of your compressed files with this selection will become uncompressed. This means that each file will be in the computer's memory at a much larger size. Therefore, it's listed as higher memory. However, since the file is already uncompressed by the time the player plays the game, the CPU doesn't need to do anything to uncompress during gameplay, so this option is listed as low CPU. The final option is compressed, streamed, on disk, higher CPU. Once again, this means that your audio file is compressed down to an OGG file. However, this fourth option is called streamed. This means that the audio file is uncompressed in real time. Rather than your game uncompressing the entire audio file before it's used, it uncompresses it as it goes. Therefore, it's listed as being on disk instead of in memory, and is listed as higher CPU, as the CPU is uncompressing the audio in real time. This fourth option is good for music, but it's not recommended for sound effects. The box below attributes is called Target Options. Here you'll find four drop-down menus. The first drop-down menu contains mono, stereo, and 3D. This determines how your sound will be outputted to the user. Mono means that your sound is outputted through one sound channel. Most computers and televisions use stereo sound. That means it has a left and a right speaker. Mono sounds will sound the same through the left and the right speaker. Stereo uses two channels, a left and right channel. This means that your music or sound could be different on the left and right channel. This allows for panning effects, or volume control per channel, or whatever is necessary for your music. We'll talk about this later in code, but if you're planning to use audio emitter functions to create 3D sound effects, you should probably indicate this here. Otherwise, you can just choose mono or stereo, depending on the use that the sounds are going to be put to. Below that, you'll find a dropdown that has 8-bit and 16-bit inside. This is used to determine the range of your audio. 16-bit has a greater range than 8-bit. It's best to just leave this option at 16-bit. Next, we have sample rate. This dropdown will contain all of the possible sample rates for the file type you've chosen. It defaults to 44.1. 44.1 is the typical sample rate of CD audio. It's a fairly decent sample rate, and you can probably leave all of your sounds and music at 44.1. But if for some reason your game is of higher quality and you'd like higher quality audio, 48 is a good option. DVDs use 48. In contrast, Blu-ray uses 96, which is double 48. But you might not have this option. I suggest leaving it at 44.1. Below that is your bitrate in kilobits per second. GameMaker defaults this selection to 192. 192 is a very standard bitrate, especially for MP3s. However, some people prefer their MP3s to be 256 or 320. Since you're making a game and not releasing music, you could probably leave your bitrate at 192 and not go any higher. This will keep your file size lower and still have a decent sound. Most of the time you won't have to worry about these settings, as the defaults are all pretty good. At the lower right of the sound properties box, you'll find Edit Sound and OK. OK closes the sound properties box and saves all the information and size. Edit Sound will take you to an external sound editing program. Your external sound editor can be set up in the Preferences window for GameMaker. Once you're done setting up all of these options, you can click OK, and GameMaker will save this sound.